In this video, we're solving a kinetic friction problem where a skier starts from rest and slides straight down a hill angled at 18 degrees. We're given the coefficient of friction, and that's 0.15. So in the first part of the problem, we're asked for the skier's acceleration, and then in part B, we use that acceleration to calculate the total distance traveled in the first 5 seconds. So, like so many dynamics problems, the whole key to this thing is to get a complete force diagram into the picture. So we start with the force of gravity, which always pulls straight down. So there's mg pulling straight down. And if you're wondering why the force of gravity is mg, I just made a very short video for that, and I'll post a link at the top real quick. Next, we draw the perpendicular to the incline, and we're doing this because we want to analyze all forces in a coordinate system that's tilted to align with the incline. In this tilted coordinate system, the acceleration will occur directly along the coordinate axis aligned with the surface, so this is by far the best way to analyze the problem. And one of the interesting points about this system is that the angle between the vertical and the perpendicular to the surface is the same as the angle of incline. So that's this angle right here. That's going to be the same as the angle of incline, so that's going to be 18 degrees as well. And I'll post a link at the top to the video where we showed why this is true. Next, we decompose the force of gravity into components that are perpendicular and parallel to the surface. And because this angle is the same as the angle of incline, which we're going to call theta for now, but we know it's 18 degrees, these components turn out to be mg cosine theta for the perpendicular piece and mg sine theta for the parallel piece. And that's because the perpendicular piece is adjacent to the angle, so we use the cosine to pick that out. The parallel piece is opposite to the angle, so we use the sine to pick that out. And note in this triangle that mg is the hypotenuse of this tilted right triangle. Be very careful in your diagrams when you're decomposing these forces. Note that these two vector components are at right angles to each other, and they add head to tail to get the original weight vector. That's why it's legal to decompose vectors into components. Next, we move mg sine theta to attach to the skier, and this just makes the problem more intuitive. That's the component of the force of gravity pulling the skier down the ramp, so let's attach it to the skier. Now we get the normal force into the diagram. Normal force always pushes perpendicular to a surface, and it does precisely what it has to do in order to keep the object constrained to the surface. Sometimes it's even called a force of constraint. In this case, a component of gravity is pulling the skier into the surface with a magnitude of mg cosine theta. So the normal force is going to exactly balance that force with a magnitude of mg cosine theta pointing away from the surface. And this guarantees the skier doesn't fly off the surface or sink into the surface. And I want to point out that this is actually the application of Newton's second law in the perpendicular direction. We just used the fact that the perpendicular acceleration is zero to conclude that the net force is zero in that direction. Finally, we get the friction force into the diagram, and this will oppose the direction of the slipping along the snow. Now that friction force depends on how large the normal force is, but we'll put that into the equations later because things are just getting a little crowded. Now that we have a complete force diagram, we're ready to apply Newton's second law in the parallel direction. And we're going to make our positive direction the actual direction of acceleration here. So I'm going to start our analysis from the very beginning, which is Newton's second law. F net equals ma, but we can look at this in components, and what we're looking at is the parallel component, so I'll write it that way. F net parallel is equal to the mass of this skier multiplied by the parallel part of the acceleration. So now we put in all the forces. That's why we put the effort into this force diagram. And F net is going to be a positive mg sine theta because we chose that as our positive direction, minus the force of kinetic friction. And that's going to be equal to m times a parallel, the acceleration down the slope. Now we'll go ahead and plug in the fact that kinetic friction force is given by the coefficient of kinetic friction, that's 0.15 in this problem, multiplied by the normal force, that's mg cosine theta. And by keeping our problem symbolic from the very beginning here, we're able to see that the mass cancels out of the equation. And this means all skiers are going to accelerate down this slope with the same rate. So we've actually isolated a parallel already. That's the acceleration down the slope, so that's what we're trying to solve for. and we get a parallel. And on the right-hand side, I'll go ahead and factor a g out. So we get g times the quantity sine theta minus mu k cosine theta. So now it's time to go ahead and plug in our numbers for the problem, and we're going to use the approximation of g as 9.8 meters per second squared. So our acceleration is given by 9.8 times the quantity sine of 18 degrees minus 0.15 cosine 18 degrees. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get an acceleration of about 1.63 meters per second squared. Okay, now we get to the follow-up question, and this is really just a one-dimensional kinematics problem. Now that we know the acceleration and we know it's constant, we should be able to compute the distance traveled in the first 5 seconds. So if I just list my kinematic variables real quick, my initial position, I'm going to call that 0. My initial velocity, also 0, because we were told the skier started from rest. My acceleration just turned out to be 1.63 meters per second squared. And then the time for the process, we're told is 5 seconds. We're interested in how far the skier slides in 5 seconds. So we bring up our basic constant acceleration kinematics formula describing the position as a function of time. That's x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. We're already solving for the final position. Now x naught is 0, v naught is 0, and I get this simple expression of 1/2 at squared, and we're going to go ahead and plug in the numbers. 1.63 for the acceleration and 5 for the time. And when I run the numbers on this to three significant digits, I get 20.4 meters. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.